I wasn't joking, but I'll tell you my name only if you manage to make it back alive. My frequency is 145.73.
She's also in charge of recording your mission data. Whenever you want to save, send a message over the reserved save frequency, 140.96.
So saving lets me record my mission data.
That's right. It also records the state of your health.
Good to know.
There's one more person I want to introduce you to, Snake.
Huh?
Speaking of snakes, you remember the boss, don't you? A legendary soldier and your mentor. Actually, it was the boss that got the DCI's authorization in the first place. She's going to be serving as Fox's mission advisor.
The boss is?
She also helped me plan this mission. She and I were at SAS together.
Jack, is that you? How many years has it been?
Boss?
That's right. It's me.
Oh.
Talk to me. Let me hear your voice.
It's been 5 years, 72 days, and 18 hours.
You've lost weight.
You can tell just by the sound of my voice.
Of course I can. I know all about you.
Really? Well, I don't know anything about you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Why'd you disappear on me all of a sudden?
I was on a top secret mission.
Hmm.
You didn't need me anymore.
But there were still so many things I wanted you to teach me.
No, I taught you everything you needed to know about fighting techniques. I taught you all I could. The rest you needed to learn on your own.
Techniques, sure. But what about how to think like a soldier?
How to think like a soldier? I can't teach you that. A soldier needs to be strong in spirit, body, and technique. And the only thing you can learn from someone else is technique. In fact, technique doesn't even matter. What's most important is spirit. Spirit and body are like two sides of a single coin. They're the same thing. I can't teach you how to think. You'll just have to figure it out for yourself. Listen to me, Jack. Just because soldiers are on the same side right now doesn't mean they always will be. Having personal feelings about your comrades is one of the worst sins you can commit. Politics determine who you face on the battlefield. And politics are a living thing. They change along with the times. Yesterday's good might be tomorrow's evil.
Is that why you abandoned me?
No, it had nothing to do with you. I already told you, Jack, I was on a top secret mission. A soldier has to follow whatever orders he's given. It's not his place to question why. But you're looking for a reason to fight. You're a natural born fighter, but you're not quite a soldier. A soldier is a political tool, nothing more. That's doubly true if he's a career soldier. Right and wrong have no place in his mission. He has no enemies and no friends. Only the mission. You follow the orders you're given. That's what being a soldier is.
I do whatever I have to get the job done. I don't think about politics.
That's not the same thing. Sooner or later, your conscience is going to bother you. In the end, you have to choose whether you're going to live as a soldier or just another man with a gun. There's a saying in the Orient, loyalty to the end. Do you know what it means?
Being patriotic.
It means devoting yourself to your country.
I follow the president and the top brass. I'm ready to die for them if necessary.
The president and the top brass won't be there forever. Once their terms are up, others will take their place.
I follow the will of the leader, no matter who's in charge.
People aren't the ones who dictate the missions.
Then who does?
The times. People's values change over time, and so do the leaders of a country. So there's no such thing as an enemy in absolute terms. The enemies we fight are only enemies in relative terms, constantly changing with the times. As long as we have loyalty to the end, there's no point in believing in anything, even in those we love.
And that's the way a soldier's supposed to think.
The only thing we can believe in with absolute certainty is the mission, Jack.
All right, but do me a favor.
What is it?
Call me Snake.
Snake? Oh, right. Your code name is Snake. It suits you well.
That's right. The legendary unit that the boss put together during World War II was a snake. The Cobra Unit, a group of heroes that brought the war to an end and saved the world. A As long as you've got a legendary hero backing you up, you'll be fine. Isn't that right, Snake?
Yeah. I can't think of anyone else I'd rather have with me. Oh, and one more thing, boss.
Yes?
It's good to hear your voice again.
Same here. After all, who knows if either of us will make it out alive? Snake, you are always best at urban warfare and infiltrating buildings. But this is the jungle. Survival is going to be key. Those CQC techniques I taught you are sure to come in handy.
CQC? Close quarters combat, huh? I've been in the Green Berets for the past few years. I'm probably pretty rusty.
Not to worry. I'll be here to help you remember. After all, this is your first actual survival mission. I'll be supporting you over the radio.
Where are you, boss? Next to the Major?
The boss is communicating with us by radio from aboard a permit-class submarine in the Arctic Ocean.
My frequency is 141.80. Call me if you need my advice on battle techniques.
Gotcha.
Your mission is to retrieve Dr. Sokolov. Dr. Sokolov is being held in an abandoned factory located to the north of your current position. Avoid heavy combat and don't let anyone see you. Don't forget that this is a stealth mission.
Snake, try to remember some of the basics of CQC.
Commencing virtuous mission now. Huh.